Hello developers, welcome to the channel. Next in the Vuex tutorial series, we will learn how we should organize APIs. Here in the source store action.js, here we have used the API like this. And it is not the best practice. Now consider the situation when we have to use these APIs number of places. And what if we have to change the domain name or we have to change its endpoint? So it will be a big headache to change these everywhere in the project. To solve this problem, I'll show you the best technique to organize the APIs. And I also want to mention that I'm showing this technique in the Vue.js project, but it can be used in any other front-end frameworks like React or any front-end framework. Before starting, a quick reminder, if you are new to this channel, hit the red subscribe button and press bell icon so you can never miss our upcoming videos. So our first step is to create APIs directory. And here in this API directory, I'll create api.js. Now in this api.js, I will import this axios and here we'll say const api is equal to axios.create and here we'll say base URL is equal to our base URL is this. Next here we'll say export default API. Now here you will see that our API is to fetch all products and this is for single product. And then here we are fetching cart and single cart items, so on. So next here we'll create product.js, which will have APIs related to products. And here we'll import API from API. And here we'll say export default. Now here we'll create methods according to our API requirements. Like right here we are fetching all products. So here we'll say all and it will return api.get and then here our endpoint is products. That's all. And now here we will use import APIs product. And here we'll say product. Now we can remove this and here we'll say product.all and then we can handle the response. Now here in this all method, this api.get will return a promise and then we can handle promise like this. Now let's see this, refresh, and it is working exactly the same. Similarly for this, here in this API, we are fetching the single product using this product ID. So here we can create another method show and it will accept the ID. Next, here we return api.get in template literals, we pass products/ID. And now we can use this method right here. So here we can remove this and here we'll say product.show and then we pass this product ID right here and then after the response we can handle it like this. Now let's see this, refresh, and we click here single product and it is working the same. Similarly, we can add more methods according to the requirement and that we can use like this, which is very clean. Next, here we are using this API for cart. So here we are create another file cart.js. Similar like product.js, here we'll say import API and here we'll say export default and then we will return methods related to carts. Now here you can see we are sending post request to this API path to store product in the carts. So here we create method store and it will accept data. and here we'll say return API dot post. Here our endpoint is this card. Next we pass this data like this. Similarly, next here we import card from API card, and now here instead of this we say card dot store, then we pass this data like this, and now we can remove this. Let's see if it is working. Add to cart. Here we can see the products in the cart. Refresh and it is fetched from the API. Same thing here, we hit this API to fetch the cart items. So next here we'll say all, and it will return API dot get, and here our endpoint is cart. Now we can remove this, and here we'll say cart dot all, and then we can handle our response. Let's see, and here this result is fetched from the API. Next here we are sending the delete request to remove the product from the cart. So our next step is to create delete method, and here we return API dot delete, and then this is our endpoint. Copy this and we will paste it right here. Instead of this product ID, here we pass ID, and this delete method will also accept ID. We need to pass this in template literal like this. Next here we can say cart dot delete, and then we pass this product ID like this. Now we can remove this axios request. Let's see this also if it is working. Remove the cart item, and it is working. Our next request is this, where we are sending delete request to clear the cart items. So next here we create another method. Let's say delete all, and here we'll return API dot delete, and here our endpoint is cart. Now we can remove this, and here we'll say cart dot delete all. All is done here. Now we can remove this import axios from here. Now let's see this. Refresh. Add product to the cart. Clear cart items, and it is cleared from there. Now here you can see how well organized is this API. Now we can use this API anywhere in the project, which is easy to understand what this API is doing behind the scene. Like this product.all, which clear indicates that we are fetching the all products from the API, and this product.show, where we are fetching the product based on this product ID, and it is easier to read and easy to maintain. Now here you can see we are repeating this cart, so avoid this. We can also create here variable const endpoint is equal to cart, and then we can use that right here like this. Now in the future, if we need to change this, we have one place to change it, and it will be reflected everywhere. We can do same thing in the product.js also. Here our endpoint is product, and we can use it like this. Let's see this, and it is working exactly the same. This is all in this video. In the next video, we will learn about namespace and modules. So thanks for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button, share this video, and don't forget to subscribe us. See you in the next video.